I've modified this thing to be able to remove the cylinder from the sleeve and be able to get it a little easier. So let's get this tray out. And it's got these two strips covering the pins and springs and everything. So we're gonna take these off. Let's start with this.
Louie, that's enough. Louis, that's enough. Louie. Louie, stop. Just lost two springs, hold on. Louie, enough.
So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6. Chamber one's just a stirring bias bearing. There goes somewhere right here. Cylinder turn. I need to go get a screwdriver, but you're right back. And so for this, I notched this out, and I also dremeled off the little nubs in there to be able to kind of lock it in place, but not where it won't come out. And now it slides in and out pretty easily, which is nice. Be able to take it apart, put it back together. Housing. Make sure to close up the key and the pins. So the little reverse T pins on all but chamber 6 on the, the right side, and then chamber 1 on the left side is just the ball bearing centering. They don't really have too much bite to get out of this spool section, but it's a little weird feedback. And that's it for this one.